Hello guys, welcome back, and today I'm gonna talk about Shokugeki no Sōma. In this modern day and age, every story has been done to death, and there is not much room for innovation. So the writer, the author of Shokugeki no Sōma, acknowledged that, and he took every anime cliche you can think of and dialed it up to 100. Shokugeki no Sōma is not innovative in the sense that it hasn't been done before. It's like he watched a show on the food channels and was inspired by it. And that's what is amazing, because this show is freaking amazing. If you haven't watched it, I will just give you the general idea. Sōma and his father were running a restaurant together, and one day his father Joichiro just up and left. So Sōma has to go to elite school for food students, chefs, and he has to prove himself there to save his restaurant and to beat his father in cooking. So this is a pretty basic idea. You set a benchmark, school for elite students and everything like that, but Sōma gives it a little bit of a unique touch. First of all, everything here is over the top. If you go in there and expecting a serious anime, something a little more deep in meaning, you're not gonna get that. It's just a fun anime to watch. Well, first of all, Sōma, this anime has one of the most over the top tsunderes you can think of. It has fan service that Fairytale would be ashamed of to call it fan service, and it practically introduced a new word into the dictionary called foodgasms. I cannot even think that you could have foodgasms, and it's an absolute delight to watch. If you watch one of these episodes before eating something, you're gonna feel pretty much satisfied after whatever you eat, for you will be pretty much prepared for a good meal after that. This anime also has a likable protagonist in Sōma. Well, this is he is from the long branch of anime characters who don't have any specific idea who their mother is. Like, I'm still waiting for Luffy's mom. Come on, dudes, let me know. In what he is confident and he's accepting, but pretty much a bland protagonist if you think about it from a different perspective. What makes Sōma work is the intense passion for food and his quite brilliant innovations, and his way to make food look so good. And everybody in the show is quite absolutely telling us every time that Sōma is a pure genius, and he looks like a pure genius in the show, in the context of the show at least. He's absolutely amazing, and that's what makes his character a little more interesting. And the fact that I love most about him is that he's never afraid of a challenge. I mean, never. He loses, and then even then he's not afraid of the challenge of the skill gap, and that's what makes his character work. Antagonists in the show are kinda one note, but they get a lot more development when they switch over the sides and become friends to Sōma, and that's a little bit of a downer, because never in the show it feels like that Sōma is fighting someone who's truly evil, and that's what kind of life is. No one is really truly evil in that sense, but they are a big obstacle towards Sōma, and as an obstacle to Sōma, they do a perfect job. Every time the enemy is hyped up, so much so that you have to consider that Sōma is going to lose or win, and Sōma doesn't always win in the show. Spoiler alert, he wins a lot, but he doesn't always win, and that's what makes it interesting, and you just watch it to enjoy it. The songs are epic, the lighting is epic, the way they visualize food is epic. So everything makes you want to watch this show. And I'm kind of a fan of the overpowered main character who just devastates everybody. I like that kind of show. And if you like that kind of show, Shokugeki no Sōma is for you. And if you don't like that kind of show, you can still watch it for the heck of it. And one of the most amazing things about this anime is that it never gets boring while you watch it. You can see it, you can enjoy it, and eventually you will probably be satisfied. So you should definitely check out Shokugeki no Sōma. And if you are thinking that what should I check out about Sōma, you can pretty much get an overall general idea of Sōma in the very first episode of Sōma. The very first episode tells you everything you need to know about the show. What it will have, what it will deliver, what it is about. The first show is a very good pilot episode, and if you like that, you should probably check it out. And yeah, that's it.